Allah says in the Qur'an, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 120, Walan tarda, anka alyahoodu, walan nasara, hatta tattabi’a millatahum. The Jews and the Christians, they will never be satisfied until you follow their brand of religion, until you follow their way of life. Allah says in the Qur'an in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 111, Waqaloo yadkhula aljannata illa man kana hoodan or nasara. They say, the Jews and Christians, you Muslims, you shall never enter Jannah unless you become a Jew or a Christian. With all your piety, with all your Salaah, with the mark on your forehead, with the fasting you do in the month of Ramadhan, with Hajj you have performed, you shall never enter Jannah unless you become a Jew or a Christian. Allah says, Tilka amaniyuhum. This is the wishful thinking. Bakwas e bakwas. Kul, tell them. Hatu buranakum. Produce your proof. In kuntum sadiqeen, but if you're truthful. Allah says, if anyone makes tall claims, tell them. Hatu buranakum. Produce your proof. In kuntum sadiqeen, but if you're truthful. And the Christians, they have produced the Bible in no less than 2,000 different languages. They say, my Bible says this, my Bible says that. My Bible says this, my Bible says that. What do we have to do? Do we have to follow the Bible hook, line, and sinker? When anyone shows you his identity card, what do? You verify whether that card is correct or not. So when they are telling you the Bible is the word of God, what do we have to do? We have to analyze the scriptures. How many of us Muslims are analyzing the scriptures? How many of us? Leave aside we doing dawah to them with their scriptures. These Christian missionaries, they are using our Quran against us. The Christian missionaries, they come knocking at a door and they ask us a question. They come knocking at the doors of the Muslims and they ask us a question that isn't it mentioned in the Quran that Bible is the word of God? And most of us will say yes. Then the next question is, then why don't you follow the Bible? And we have got no reply. That's the next question. That how many times is the name of your last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, mentioned in the Quran? If you know, you will say 5 times. 4 times as Muhammad and 1 as Ahmad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How many times is the name of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, mentioned in the Quran? If you don't know, they will tell you, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, by name, is mentioned 25 times in the Quran. There's the next question. Who's greater? A person who's mentioned 5 times by name in the Quran is greater, or a person who's mentioned 25 times by name in the Quran is greater? That's the question, but they'll not give you the reply. They'll let your mind think. There's the next question. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, did he have a father and mother? We say, yes, he had a father and mother. Did Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did he have a father and mother? We have to agree. That as for the teaching of the Quran, Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, had a mother, but he had no father. That's the next question. Who's greater? A person who has a father is greater, or a person who does not have a father is greater? A person who's born by the help of the father is greater, or a person who's born without a father is greater? Who's greater? A person who has a father is greater, or a person who does not have a father is greater? Who's greater? Who's greater? They ask the question, but they don't give you the reply. They let your mind think. They are using us Muslims as punching bags, as doormats. They are making nest in our head, and we can't even open our mouth. It's a shame. That's the next question. That, did your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam do any miracles? We say, yes, he did several miracles. Do you know of any miracle in which he gave life to the dead? And we have to agree that nowhere does the Quran or any hadith say that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave life to the dead. That's the next question. Did Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did he give life to the dead? And we have to agree, the Quran says, Biznillah, wake up in the name of Allah. Yes, he gave life to the dead. So who's greater? A person who can give life to the dead is greater, or a person who cannot give life to the dead is greater? Who's greater? A person who can give life to the dead is greater, or a person who cannot give life to the dead is greater? Who's greater? Who's greater? Who? The question is, who's greater? When you say who's greater in English, it has to be one of the two, unless your English is weak. They ask the question, but they don't give you the reply. They let your mind think. That's the next question. That your Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is he physically dead or alive? And we have to agree. Physically, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam dead. He's buried in Medina. Is Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is he physically dead or alive? We have to agree that he's alive. The Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse 158, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised him up alive. So who's greater? A prophet who's dead is greater, or a prophet who's alive is greater? They ask the question, but they don't give you the reply. They let your mind think. They use us Muslims as punching bags, as doormats, and we can't even open our mouth. See, doing da'wah is very easy. If you read the Quran with understanding, and if you keep your mind open, doing da'wah is very easy. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, Kul, ya ahl al-kitab, say, O people of the book, ta'alu ila kalmatin sawa'in bayna baynakum, come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah, na'budu illallah. That we worship none but Allah. Wala nushrika bihi shay'an, that we associate no partners with him. Wala yattakhiza ba'duna ba'dan arbaban min dunillah, that we erect not among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. Fantawallah. If then they turn back. Fakulu shadu, say ye be witness. Bi anna muslimun, that we are Muslims bowing our will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This verse of the glorious Quran, Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, according to me, is the master key as far as da'wah to non-Muslim is concerned. Is the master key for da'wah. It says, ta'alu ila kalmatin sawa'in bayna baynakum, come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah na'budu illallah, that we worship none but Allah. Wala nushrika bihi shay'an, that we associate no partners with him. And if you see the tapes and the lectures that I've given, all these questions have been answered. How to do da'wah has been explained. It's so easy. The only thing you have to do is open your mouth.